Welcome to Copilot Studio Agent Academy. This is Mission 8, Enhance User Interactions in Topics with Adaptive Cards. My name is Elaiza Benitez, and I'm a cloud advocate at Microsoft. In this mission, we'll explore what adaptive cards are, understand the role of JSON in their structure, and how PowerFX can be used instead of JSON. We'll also learn about the Adaptive Card Designer and common use cases for adaptive cards. Lastly, we'll dive into adding an adaptive card to a topic. Let's get started. So what are adaptive cards? Adaptive cards are structured JSON objects that create visually rich interactive components that can be embedded in apps like Teams, Outlook, and Copilot Studio agents. Adaptive cards make conversations more engaging by turning plain text into interactive elements like buttons, forms, and images that automatically adjust to the application's look and feel. For example, rather than asking, "What's your name?" as simple text, you can create a professional form card with input fields that seamlessly collects and uses data in your agent's conversation flow. Now, adaptive cards use JSON. And no, it's not a person. JSON stands for JavaScript Object Notation. It's a lightweight data format that uses key-value pairs in curly braces. For adaptive cards, JSON defines the card structure by specifying what elements appear and how they're arranged, while also determining user actions, like submitting forms or opening links. The beauty of JSON is that it's easy to read and write, making it accessible even for non-developers who want to create interactive card experiences. Now, previously, we learned about PowerFX, which is a programming language from Power Apps that uses Excel-like syntax. In Copilot Studio, you can use PowerFX as an alternative to JSON when you want to create dynamic adaptive cards with your data. With PowerFX, you can dynamically insert values like username and dates, format text and numbers, and show or hide elements based on conditions and user input. For example, using a formula to combine the word hello and the system variable of user display name allows you to personalize and make your adaptive cards more engaging. To design these cards, we use the Adaptive Card Designer. This is a visual drag-and-drop interface that lets you build interactive message cards without complex coding. The tool includes 5 key components. On the left, there's card elements for adding text blocks and buttons. Then in the middle, we have the card viewer for real-time preview. Next to it, there's the card structure for organizing elements. And then we have element properties for customization, and at the bottom, a card payload editor for advanced users. The workflow is simple. Design visually, see a live preview, fine-tune properties, and the designer automatically generates the JSON code for you. Adaptive cards are commonly used for forms and data collection. Examples are leave requests and appointment scheduling. And for dynamic information, you can display summaries or real-time data from your enterprise systems like ServiceNow or Dynamics 365. You also have interactive choices where a user could select from a list of options. These cards enable static text conversations to include actionable elements such as submit buttons or view detail links, which can further the conversation flow or provide additional information. This approach results in an interaction that is more structured and functional compared to traditional text-only conversations. In this lab today, we're going to add a topic with an adaptive card that allows users to select from a list of choices and submit the response. We'll use PowerFX to display data from a SharePoint list, and lastly, update the agent instructions to invoke the new topic. The end result is a topic that can handle device requests from users through an adaptive card. Now, before we begin, make sure you've already completed the earlier missions. You'll need a dedicated development environment and access to the SharePoint site that you would have created in the core setup mission. Let's begin. Let's start by creating our new topic dedicated to device requests. Go to the Topics tab and select Add a Topic from blank. Name this topic Request Device and copy and paste this description from the lab exercise. This creates a focused topic specifically for handling device requests. Now for the exciting part. We're going to add an adaptive card instead of plain text. Select the Ask with Adaptive Card node. This is what makes our conversation visual and interactive. When you select the node, the Adaptive Card node properties pane will appear, giving us access to the powerful card designer. Select Edit Adaptive Card to open the Adaptive Card designer. This is where the magic happens. Try dragging and dropping text block and fact set elements to see how the designer works in real time. Notice how the card structure and payload editor updates automatically. This visual feedback helps you understand the relationship between design elements and the underlying JSON code. Select Preview to see your card at different screen widths. This shows how adaptive cards automatically adapt to different devices and screen sizes. Exit from Preview and select Undo to remove the test elements we added. Now let's use a pre-built template to accelerate our development. Select all content in the card payload editor and delete it. Then paste the JSON from the request device's JSON file in the lab exercise. This gives us a professional-looking card with device selection capabilities, the ability to enter a comment, and submit the request. Save the adaptive card and exit from the designer. Scroll to the bottom of the node to see the output variables of comments ID and device selection ID. These variables automatically capture what users select and type in the card, making this data available to use later in our conversation flow. Now we're going to make our card truly dynamic by converting from static JSON to a PowerFX formula. Select the card, then select the chevron icon and choose formula. Select the expand icon to enlarge the formula field. Currently, the card is displaying static data of devices, so we'll update this to pull data from the device's SharePoint list. Clear the existing content and paste our PowerFX formula from the request device formula file in the lab exercise. This formula uses the for all function to loop through each SharePoint item from our global variable, displaying the device model in the title and using the SharePoint ID as the value. The if is blank functions checks for missing data. This ensures the card still displays properly, even when some information is missing. Close the card model and the adaptive card node properties pane. We've updated the adaptive card with PowerFX formulas to show available devices from SharePoint in a dynamic and interactive way. Now we need to update the agent instructions to create a logical conversation flow where users can move from browsing available devices to actually requesting one. First, save the topic. Next, navigate to the Overview tab and select Edit in the Agent Instructions section. We're going to add a new instruction that creates conditional logic. Copy and paste this instruction from the lab exercise. This instruction creates a branching conversation path based on user intent. Now for the technical implementation. Select the entire topic placeholder request device in square brackets and delete it. Type /request and select the request device's topic. This creates a direct reference that tells our agent exactly which topic to invoke when the conditions are met. Let's repeat the same process for the goodbye placeholder. Delete the placeholder, type /goodbye, and select the goodbye topic. This creates a complete decision tree. If users want to request advice, they go to our Request Advice's adaptive card topic. If they decline, they get a polite goodbye through the goodbye topic. Save these updated instructions to activate the new routing logic. Now for the exciting part. Let's test our adaptive card and the updated agent instructions to handle conditional logic. Refresh the testing pane and select the activity map icon. Enter the question, "I need a laptop," to trigger the conversation orchestration. Watch how our agent responds with a list of available devices and then asks if the user wants to request one. Type yes to see the magic happen. The agent intelligently recognizes the affirmative response and seamlessly transitions from the available devices topic to our request device topic. We'll next see the adaptive card with interactive elements showing the available devices dynamically populated from SharePoint. This represents a complete transformation from simple text exchanges to rich interactive experiences. Mission accomplished. You've learned how to create an adaptive card and display data from a SharePoint list using PowerFX formulas. You also learned how to update the agent instructions to invoke the topic that contains the adaptive card. And that wraps up Mission 8 of the Copilot Studio Agent Academy. So keep experimenting, keep building, and as always, keep learning. We'll see you in the next mission of the Agent Academy.